Well, here we are again. And
meow. A tiny, super tight.
Gee, the little super tight. Well. Is declare your glory, your heavens declare your glory. Your heavens declare. So I was thinking of doing a reminder study. Russell's Zodiac. Email, defined words.
Yeah.
You'll notice up here for zero, I have Obama. And that's because the universe sent me this. I think this was let me double check. Wait for the spinning ball to show up here. Yeah, it was mean tweets. President Obama did some Jimmy Kimmel Live mean tweets. This was just a couple days ago. So, the reason why I put that in there. There we go. Reload it. The reason why I put that in there is, because it was a synchronization video. In other words, as I was doing my study, the universe sent this video to me. on the sidebar. Or it was on the new YouTube function, which is the automatic video play. So I had the YouTube playing in the background. And Obama's mean tweet came up. And so I put it in here in the numbered order sequence. As I was numbering all these things in order as they were coming up. I just came up with an idea. I'll do that probably next time. The idea was to plug my headset into my interface. My audio interface. So as we can see here on the the Safari's dragging, so probably have to force quit Safari. No, I won't do that yet. I think what I'll do is I'll pause the video. This doesn't have any functions up at top. So what I'll do is I'll shrink this up, press pause. And see if that will help the video. Nope. So let's force quit out of Safari and play the video again. It's just too loud for me right now. I'm going to turn that down. So now let's go over here to Safari and bring that page up. Tell you what we're gonna do. We're gonna make a half Safari page, and let's see if it will. Not allowing me to make a bookmark. It's not allowing me to save anything. So let's just bring Obama back up. This was an interesting Obama tweet because we got to see Obama's actual reaction. Now remember, these actions, reactions are universal. So if we identify with the reactions, then the universe will attach an emotion to it. And those emotions can be detrimental or, okay, so we have an error. So I need to shut off the video. Okay, so let's try it again. Just gotta wait for it to redo itself, and it didn't want to refresh to the page that I wanted, so we'll just wait for it. Put this thing there. That's what I got. Let's see if we can get this thing to. Safari is dragging again. So we'll force quit out of Safari again. And bring it back up. Obama back up. What I'll probably have to do is probably have to make a video conversion. So, let's see what video we have here. All right, so that's the right video. So let's do a video conversion here. It should only take a couple. A little bit of time here. Please enter and paste a valid let's see if we can get this thing to validate. That's not what I wanted to do there. So you can see how maintaining nice relaxation when we enter into a nice feel-good relaxation state, then then the universe will give us all the desires of our heart. The key is to be totally relaxed. We don't have to do anything. No actions are required. All that's required is just focusing on being still and relaxed. And then the universe will automatically manifest everything we desire without us having to lift a finger. That includes providing energy. We can actually just sit here as long as we want and not have to eat any food. Because we're now, instead of using gasoline to fuel our bodies, we're using H2O. And you get about, or we also have the option to use magnetic power, which I think I'll switch over to, and I'll call it magnetic power. So, there we go, mean tweets. Wasn't the one I want. Here it is. You all don't see it, but I have a spinning ball. Okay, so here we are. Copy this. And we're going to go over here. Go back to home base.
A tiny cleaning. She's having a good time. She's cleaning herself. A tiny. I put a tiny cleaner, yeah, yeah. I put the tiny cleaner, yeah, yeah.
There we go. Okay. Should be able to download this pretty soon. Download. Now I know why Obama was chosen to be president, because the universe had to usher in a president that knew how to handle being in the public eye of YouTube videos. So, that's the strong points of President Obama and First Lady Michelle is they're very down to earth. Very down to earth and transparent, so. So that makes me want to look up, see when Obama's birthday was, see what his zodiac sign is. I think I already looked it up, though. Got another spinning ball. Alright, there we go. We'll get to that a little bit. Put that down here. So let's look up Obama's birthday. Yep, he's Leo. Or, wait. Let's just do it this way. Zodiac. Obama Zodiac. Oh, okay, so here's yeah, it says late. Well, let's see where is it. See if it gives us a So as you can see right here, Obama's mostly on one side of the zodiac. He has three signs on one side, and the rest of the planets are all on the other side. Oh, there's a little, he's got a moon down there. Okay, so. So this must be Sun Leo, so he's a Leo. Rising might be Aquarius, Scorpio. Moon was in Gemini. Dominant house is 674, air fire fixed. So let's go back here and double check this, see what this one says. This says he's Leo, so he's more of a centered Leo. When I say centered Leo, I'm saying that see if I can highlight this. Wait for the spinning ball here. There we go. Wait for the spinning ball. I hear some talking somewhere. Maybe it's this other video over here. It's probably what it is. So we're continuing to wait for spinning balls here. Probably the reason we're spinning balls is because... Now this guy, I liked his answer. I remember seeing him. Let's see if we can... shut this one off here. There we go. It's one of playing the YouTube videos, it makes everything drag. Alright, so here we are. Now, I'll wait for this thing to do its... spinning balls, I gotta slow everything down. The Holt Center. Alright, there we go. So. So I gotta press it. And wait for it. See, there we go. I have to go real slow with this thing. That's what it is. Okay. So. That reminds me, I have my pen. Over here, put it in the sidebar. Okay, so I should be able to write now. So, in between 23 and 22. In between that is 30 days. Or from 22 to 22 is 30 days. It's basically a month. So we'll call that our month spread. So that means that in the center here, going straight down to center, is 15 days. This thing's going too slow. There we go. 15 days. So, let's bring up our calculator. There we go. So all we gotta do, whoops. What we gotta do is quit highlighter. Okay. So we got the idea of that one. Now, 23 + 7 takes us to the end of the month. So there's our 30 right there. And then add 4 more days, because that takes us to August 4th, because as you can see up here, July 23 right there, if you add 7 to it, that takes you to July 30th, and over here we see that he was born on the 4th. See if I can get that to highlight here. So you can see the universe just gave us a cutting edge trading tools transparency pricing on the sidebar there. Okay, so here we are. That's because I'm starting to learn how to go slow. So here it is. So, like I said, 23 + 7 brings us to 30, the end of the month. You add 4 days to that, and that takes us to his birthday. So, that's 7 + 4 = 11. Whoops. 7 + 4 = 11. So there we have it. So that means that he is actually left of center. So he's more on the July side. Because here's the center right here. Here's July over here. There's July. And over here we have August. And President Obama was born over here. 4 is on the left side because it would actually be, we got 23 down here, for the 23rd of July. We add 7 to that. That takes us to 30. 23 plus 7 is 30. Put a plus sign right here. Okay. And so like I said, 30. There's a total of 30 days between July 23 and August 23 right here. So if we split that down the middle, we have what's called 15 days, because 30 divided by 2 is 15. And so if the middle here is 15 days, then in order to get to that 15 days from July 23 over to the middle, this would be the center point. That would be 7 plus X equals 15. Okay. So, in order to figure out what X is, we have to subtract 7 from 15, and that gives us 8. So that means that 8 is the actual center point of Leo, of the month, or of the zodiac sign called Leo. Whoops. So, don't want to do that. So, here would be the zodiac wheel, the triangle, like that. And the exact center is the 8th of the month. We just go down the center. And over here, this triangle over here is Virgo. Virgo. And this triangle over here is Cancer. Okay. And Yngwie Malmsteen is a Cancer. So, as we can see right here, this number four right here is left of center. So, President Obama leans more toward Yngwie Malmsteen, which is the sign of Cancer. But he is pretty close to center right here. That's why I call him a centered Leo. Now, the way we figure this out, that he's in the center, is we divide this triangle into three, because each zodiac sign is known as 30 degrees. So let's do this again. So here's our triangle. Okay. So we divide this into three. And each of the three is what's called 10 degrees. This one's 10. This one's 10. And that one's 10. Seeing how there's 12 zodiacs and a circle has 360 degrees in it for the zodiac circle. When I say circle, because the zodiac is a big giant circle, just like that, and it's divided up into fours, and then each four is divided up into two. And it's just like a large Pizza Hut pizza where I used to work, and I used to run the cut table at a couple thousand miles per hour and cut those large pizzas. So, if there's 12 zodiac signs, then all we got to do is divide 12 or 360 degrees. That'd be 360 degrees. Divide that by 12. And that equals 30. So that's why we have each zodiac sign is 30 degrees. So over here, each of these little pizza slices is 30 degrees. Everyone. It's 30 degrees. All the way around. And so if we divide 30 three times, then of course we get 10 degrees each. So if Leo starts on the 23rd, then we know if you add 7 to get to the end of the month, you get 30. That takes us to 30. So, if you add 3 to that, that will get your 10. So the third of the month is on the very edge right here. Right on the edge. And the 23rd is on the edge right here. So Obama is just right beginning on the other side, the fourth of the month right there. So he's actually at the very far left of center, because the center we figured out right here would be the center. We figured that that is the eighth of the month. So that's why I say that Obama is a centered Leo. But he's actually left of center of the center. So. So. That makes him, being in the center, he's categorized as a purebred Leo. He's purebred. And Leos are the type of people that like to shine. They provide lots of nutrition, lots of sunlight, which is necessary for all humankind to thrive on. So let's see if we can find what Michelle's birth sign is. There it is. She's a Capricorn. I had a feeling she was a Capricorn for some reason. See that? Something told me she was a Capricorn. Now, we don't know that for sure. So, there it is right there. Capricorn. Now, we want more confirmation on that. So, we'll go to some other websites here. Okay, now let's go back up to the top up here. We're going to put in Mrs. Obama. Now I know why. How I could sense where that down to earth feeling was coming from. It comes from Mrs. Obama. Because Capricorns are the earth sign. January 17th. Okay. So, you can see it right here. January 17th, 1964. Wow. She's 64. I was born 68, so I'm 47, so she's 51. She looks young. Young for 51. So let's find out where the 17th lies in the month. If 8 is the middle, and if we divide the pizza into 3, then if we know each one of these spaces right here is 10 degrees, then all we have to do is add 10 to 8, and 18 is the exact edge of this center. Well, actually this whole part right in here is the center deacon. This whole deacon is 10 degrees right here. So Michelle is all the way on the edge right here at 17. So she is right of center, leaning more toward Sagittarius, or no, Aquarius will be over here, AQ, Aquarius. So, I am born on the 9th, so I'm right pretty much smack dab right in the middle of center. I'm what you call a purebred. I'm just slightly to the right. I'm a purebred Capricorn. I am almost right in the middle. So, okay. So, alrighty. So let's look at President Obama's video here, and we're going to see his reactions.
Chief, and that's that. Sign out for an all-president. getting grayer these days. Can't imagine why, since he doesn't seem to be one bit worried about all that's going on.
Okay, now this was the reaction that caught my attention the most. We can tell that this was very it was hurtful to his feelings by that reaction, because we know that he cares a very great deal of what's going on. And he knows it too. And it's actually kind of a disappointing yet hurt expression. Disappointing meaning that he's feeling disappointed in the comment because the person hasn't evolved to the point to understand that there are certain men on this earth that hold a high level of knowledge, and they understand the need for keeping peace on the earth. So, but we can see by his reaction that it's a reaction of hurt feelings. It's a mixture of reactions: hurt feelings, frustration, and yet sadness. And also another element would be compassion. Because at his heart, with the knowledge that he understands about commercial law, private maritime law, he wants to see everyone grow and to be self-regulating in the areas of peace, safety, and self-responsibility, so that there's no more need for presidents anymore on the earth. Everyone will be a president. And what I mean by that is everyone will hold the knowledge and the skill of a president. That's what Mother Nature and Father Cause wants for us all to be able to do, is to maintain their nations, which is their body, which is their arms, their hands, their feet, and their fists, and their tongues, and their thoughts. All for peace and safety. Not bringing any harm to anybody. So, let's watch that reaction again.
Looking grayer these days. Can't imagine why, since he doesn't seem to be one bit worried about all that's going on. Is there any?
Okay. Let's watch it again.
Online, the people who already don't like the president are criticizing.
Johnson and Bush would get the same thing when he did TV shows. It's the nature of the job, I guess, especially now that we have Twitter. But I think it's important to remember that presidents are people, too.
I noticed this time when I watched it that there was a little twinge of irritation also.
We give celebrities a chance to read some of the mean things people tweet about them. And tonight, we extended that same courtesy to our commander-in-chief. And with that said, it's time now for an all-President Obama edition of Mean Tweets.
Obama's hair is looking grayer these days. Can't imagine why, since he doesn't seem to be one bit worried about all that's going on.
And of course, you can hear the drama effect that was added to it by the background music they played during his reaction. So, and that's what you call the power of music. These professional composers, they score movie scenes for Hollywood movies. And this is a miniature Hollywood movie right here. President Obama's up there, and he's playing his part, except everything is live, though. It's not actually acting right here. It's this is a live movie. This is the live movie of the universe that's being played right here. And so, but it has been turned into a movie because this is after the fact. It's a video now. So now it is a movie. And so they took his reactions to the editing room and they added music to it. And that would be called scoring. And so scoring is used to add atmospheric effect to a scene. So if we listen to the music again, you can see the music brought forth certain emotions. Let's listen to it again. Okay, so did you hear that? Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to play that on my guitar and I'm going to isolate it to the particular emotion that it drew up. So, check this out. Up here now. There's the music that was being played. That's an E major.
So he says, how to be read. Let's was lost, and down I fled, was lost. Yet now I see it's worth it, so it's all is found. It's
out.
Too. I like to experiment. So let's listen to the music again. Well, it was actually one half step down, so it was actually E flat. Reminds me of the opening of a Bee Gees song. So let's go back here. Let's listen to it again.
About all that's going on. Is there any way we...
This broken man,
it sounds like the Bee Gees song called How can mend a broken heart? I think that's what it's called. Let me see here. As you can see, I'm having to wait for a spinning ball here. There are many songs that start out with that number one chord. Waiting for a spinning ball, so that's what you call the number one chord.
Doe a deer, a female deer. Doe a deer, a female deer. Ray, a drop of golden sun. Ray, a drop of golden sun. Me a name to call my own. Me a name to call my own. Far a long way to run. Far a long way to run. So a needle and some thread. Ba ba no da 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 da. That will bring us back to do 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 do. Like we got the spinning ball here, so look like it stopped. So BG's. Oh, now I gotta take the batteries out and hook them back up. I do this because the batteries charge back up real quick all of a sudden when I do that. I think this is Mend a Broken Heart. Da 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 da. Boom boom. Da 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 da. That's it, da 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 da. When living for my life. Was everything a man could want to do. Never see tomorrow. Have no, no, no one said a word about. About this. Okay, so this is the key of D sharp. Da 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 da. Bam bam. Da 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 da. When living for my life was everything a man could want to do. I could never see tomorrow.
I could never see tomorrow. the sirens. And now that I've healed myself, I'm a winner, always win. I'm healthin', I'm healed and whole. Now we can live again. Ba-da-ba-da-ba.
That was just to give us a taste of that particular emotional chord and where it can lead to. But that's the number one chord. So now you can see when we want to draw an emotion with our movies or our scenes that we make, then we can use that number one chord if our scene is in this particular emotion right here. This particular emotion that we described in the video can be dramatized with the number one chord. So let's hear it again.
Obama to some golf course halfway around the world and just leave him there. Well, RW Surfer Girl.
Well, that was another one. That's not the one I wanted to emphasize. Let's go back here. Okay.
Sarah is looking grayer these days. Can't imagine why, since he doesn't seem to be one bit.
Okay, so there it was right there.
Well, hi, June.
So I'm going to hold the microphone so we can hear it better.
One bit worried about all that's going on.
Now let's actually do the whole question again so we get the full impact.
Looking grayer these days. Can't imagine why, since he doesn't seem to be one bit worried about all that's going on.
Okay, so I could make a loop of that if I wanted to, but I'd have to run it through iMovie, cut and paste and all that. So, alright. So that'll be the end here. It's probably about an hour long video. Okay. Ah, geez.